evening, good afternoon, I should say. My name is Fred Murray. I'm the owner and operator of FM Versatile Limousines. Am I talking loud enough? Okay. It's nice to be here today in this expo given by the Nubian sisters. Also, that light is so bright, but anyway. We're a full service limousine service company, and we provide limousine service for a wide variety and a wide range of functions. We specialize in weddings, of course, and we're here to service your wedding needs if possible. And I think that's it.
For Miss Josephine Jackson, Josephine does traditional and also Afrocentric cummerbands, bow ties, and favors. For weddings, bridal shows, and
hello, my name is Fred Powell, and I'm the owner of Barbara's Florist, located at 615 Nostrand Avenue in Brooklyn, New York. We are full-service florists, and we have been in business for 21 years. We do corporate accounts, catering affairs, weddings, funerals, everything in the need for flowers. So if you're in the area, do stop in and see us. Call us at 718-773-6644. We'd love to hear from you. Have a good day.
Representing Joelle's Fine Catering, we're full catering service from menus to music, and now we also have, addition to our program, we have the Midland House, located on Midland Parkway. We've been in business for about 5 years, and just give us a call. Our number is 718-526-7988, or you could reach us at 291-2303. We're located in Jamaica Estates, 8668 Midland Parkway. Thank you and enjoy.
Fred, ever since I was, 13 or 10, and her mother,
Zernas Fredo. I'm representing United Photo Associates. I'm along here with Claude Foster, the videographer. My phone number is 718-341-3076, specializing in wedding photography, portfolios, album covers, and commercial photography. And it's a pretty nice day today.
Nubian sisters, and we are bridal consultants here to help plan your wedding, whether it's European, African, or African inspired. We are the ones that put this entire show together, and we hope that our guests here will enjoy what they're seeing and come to us and ask us to plan their weddings for them. Hopefully, after the expo is over, we will have quite a number of clients to do so.
My name is Ronnie. This is Ronnie's Culinary Elegance. We are full one-stop catering service. The cake that you see on my left is custom-made designed by handmade sugar flowers. We designed and cater to suit your needs. Our menu is a variety of all type of ethnic and Caribbean dishes, soul food, and whatever you may desire. Please give us a call and we will be happy to please you. Thank you.
You are now presented with the jewels of the camera jewels of the Studio Patar. What we do is we specialize in creating an aura of the divine work of our ancestors, and every design that you see here is reflective of our great ancestry. There's nothing here that we make that's just trivial. Everything has a story and a symbolic meaning to it. We make these rings in 14 and 18 karat gold and sterling silver as well. This is exclusively for our African brothers and sisters, made with all the love and desire in our heart for all of our brothers and sisters. Hotepu, peace and love.
Hello, my name is Margot Turnquest, and I'm the owner of Occasional Tears, a baking business for special occasions and party planning. And it's a pleasure to be here this afternoon. It's a wonderful turnout. We have wonderful displays. I'm very pleased with the response that people have to my work, and hope that, you know, things go well in the future and that we can, you know, do more expos for our community at this level.
Presentation of Kings and Queens. We thank all you kings and queens for coming out and celebrating with us. Our show will be beginning shortly. But before that, we have a special guest, Ms. Harriette Cole, fashion editor for Essence Magazine and author of Jumping the Broom, who will lead us into this show by giving us some tips about our ancestors.
Hello, everyone. And welcome all the about-to-be-married people and all the folks already married, because this is a really wonderful time of great love. So we should all be really happy to be here in a celebration of our people giving to our community. It's really beautiful. I am often asked, as I travel around the country talking about Jumping the Broom, well, how can I include something cultural in my wedding? As we know, a traditional Western wedding is one where the bride wears a beautiful white gown. Normally the wedding is in a church. The food is very simple American fare with a beautiful white cake, and everything is really beautiful, but somehow the texture that is ours, that is part of our heritage, is often missing. Well, as I researched Jumping the Broom with a team of really dedicated African-American brothers and sisters who worked to find out what is there about our culture that we can include at this most sacred time in our lives, I found all kinds of things. I mean, from our own lives right now today, we can make the choice when we choose a caterer to choose somebody who knows how to make our food. You know, one of the most important parts of a wedding is the celebratory feast. But we so often don't remember how we celebrate. You know, when you have your friends over for dinner, a family member comes in town for Christmas or any other big holiday celebration, you're serving the food that we love. But so often, when we go to a catering facility for a wedding, we feel that we find ourselves at the mercy of the caterer. So we find baked chicken, white rice, and green beans. We've been to a lot of weddings like that, right? Well, that costs anywhere from $30 to $60 per person. That is a lot of money. And you know, that's not what we feed our friends when they come over to eat. So we have to remember, celebrate every aspect of our beings as we honor each other in our union and all who are coming to celebrate that union. So when we eat, let's eat our food. When we get dressed, and we're about to see lots of clothes here today, you know, one of the interesting things that we found in researching Jumping the Broom is that there are so many talented black designers across the country who are making clothes for weddings, for the bride, the groom, the little ones, the mother, the father, the whole wedding party. So we really can recycle our dollars into our community. Even if you want to wear a white dress, it's possible to wear that white dress and buy a fine white, beautiful white gown from a designer in our own community. And then we don't have to stop there. You know, our ancestors in West Africa in particular often used gilding in the fabrics that they use for their weddings. If you notice, traditional West African cloth often has gold threads or silver threads in it. But there's a reason for that. It's majestic. Think about how the gold, when we wear gold jewelry, how that gold captures sunlight and just brightens up your face that much more. When you get married, it is a majestic moment. It should be that most high majestic moment that we could ever have in our lives. And so getting dressed is important. But interesting, our ancestors, before ever putting on any clothes, had many other rituals that they incorporated into their lives. So about a month or so before the wedding, the young woman would go with all the females in the family group, with the elders, with the mother, the aunts, and everybody, and they would go away for a while in a separate area. And the women would share things about marriage that the young woman could use for the rest of her life. But also, the day before the wedding, the woman would be bathed in pure water. And this was a ceremonial bath. And after that bath, her body would be anointed with fragrant oils. Similarly, this would happen for the young man. So when the couple came together, often they would have had a cleansing diet. They would have listened to the wisdom of the elders, sharing with them how to make this marriage work. Because it's not just a wedding. It's not a one-day event, but it's a lifetime of love and challenge. So they would share all of these great things with each of the members of that union. And then when they came together, not only would they be spiritually purified, but physically they would be anointed with beautiful, provocative oils that kept that circle of love going between the two of them. Then when they were adorned in the fabric that was made in that community, it just became a very high spiritual moment for the two of them. Well, in our own country, many of you probably already know the tradition of jumping the broom, but it is a tradition that came out of the worst circumstances that our ancestors endured, slavery. When our ancestors were brought to this country, they were stripped of all rights, including the legal right to marry. But we're talking about people who had just come from their homeland, where there was never an occasion that was really a special occasion that they didn't honor in a very important way. So what our ancestors did was to take a broom, which is a symbol of householding the world over. It's also a benign symbol, nothing that the master would be afraid of. And they took that broom and often adorned it with flowers or with handmade cloth and placed it before them, or else someone would hold it up a little high so they had to jump high. And before drums were outlawed, you know those big-bellied West African drums that we often hear people play now? Well, the drum would start at a very low pitch, and whoever was officiating this union would describe what was happening, what was about to happen, and they would pledge their vows to each other. And at the point when the drums reached a crescendo, when you could feel the presence of the ancestors in that space, the couple jumped the broom. I assure you, this is a beautiful, beautiful tradition to incorporate into your wedding, into your reception. And if not jumping the broom, there are many, many other things that you can do just by remembering your family members. What did your parents do when they got married? What about your grandparents, your aunts and uncles? Do some research into your own families. And also, if you want to learn more about the way that our ancestors got married, there's a lot of information in jumping the broom. So I wish you all the best of weddings and very happy marriages and lives together. And let's enjoy the show. Thank you.
Introducing Nigerian fabrics and fashions, starting off our